Professor!
Oh, it's you, dear boy. Come in, and shut the door.
What's going on? You leaving?
Yes, sir. Yes, I am, sir. Do you know the thing? The thing that is vital, without which scholarship cannot proceed, sir?
No, I don't.
Not having a bullet in your flipping neck, sir. I am not cut out for this. No, not cut out for this at all.
Nope.
They're fucking savages! Savages!
I think we all are.
Not me, sir. I'm from Connecticut. I'm a professor at Yale. I write books. I do not deserve to die out here. Where's my tincture? Oh, yes.
You okay, Professor?
Oh, dandy, sir. Just dandy. Oh, great heavens above!
Is that you, John?
Hello, Dutch.
I think that's what they call two for the price of one out here in this wonderful place.
Maybe so, Dutch.
You and your friend there, the professor, we're gonna kill the both of you.
Why you wanna do a thing like that?
I don't know. Sport, I guess.
Fair enough. Why don't I come out there? We fight. Let the professor go and send your boys back to their families.
Well, that sounds like a beautiful plan, John. Only problem is, my boys here, they already lost their families a long time ago. We aren't thieves, John. We're fighting for something a bit like you. Only we're fighting for an idea. Not just for ourselves.
That's beautiful, Dutch. You always were a fine speaker.
I was. Now, would you kindly send that academic out here so we can show him what we really think about the art of anthropology?
Please, sir, what are we going to do?
I'm going to hand you over to him and watch him tear you limb from limb.
What?
I'm just kidding. We're going to run across the rooftops. Get you back to your ivory tower.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. We're still here. Come on.
Yes. Oh, come here.
Oh, yeah. Good day, sir. Madam.
Look here, sir. What is the meaning of this outrage?
You two stay down and shut up.
Come on. We can get to the roof this way. John! Help me, John!
One more move. And he's a dead man.
Onward!
Onward!
Five! Christ alive! What do we do now? They've got us pinned down on both sides.
You killed the guy.
Thank you.
quiet.
I have no ears for your bastard words. You damn bastard. You're a disgrace to all men.
Something will die up here.
I think that's most of them. The coast looks clear.
Come on, then. Let's make a break for it. The horses should be in an alleyway down here. Unbelievable. Come on, let's get the hell out of Blackwater. Move.
Faster.
Right, to the station. I'm not staying in this place a minute longer. This really couldn't have gone more horribly wrong.
At least you got some good material for your next book.
You know, I dreamt of documenting the last days of the Old West. The romance, the honor, the nobility. But it turns out it's just people killing each other.
It always was, Professor. And the Old West ain't quite dead yet.
Oh, I know, Mr. Marston. Believe me, I know. Giddy up! What do I have to do? I can't believe this! They're still chasing us! Trying to kill each other.
You going back to Yale?
I'm not sure I can just yet.
Hey.
Here we are. Finally. My research is complete. Much as I thought, there's no civilizing this savage land.
I could have told you that for nothing.
Ah, but they'll give me a prize in New Haven for this. Well, they bloody better. Well. Goodbye, Mr. Marston.
Best of luck, dear friend.
So long, Professor.
So long, sir.
Yeah! Come on! nowhere. Yeah.
Thank God you got them. They've done all sorts of misdeeds.
Not a problem, sir.
The serendipity is going to be restored to its prime.
What do you want, Marston?
My family. I've done what you asked.
No, you haven't. This is the land of opportunity, and I gave you the opportunity to save your family, and you failed. How could I possibly reward you?
Marston, you're a public menace. We should have had you killed.
I wish you had. But since you didn't, where's my family?
Oh, spare me the noble savage falling a sore tripe, will you, old boy? It's nauseating. You don't wish to be dead. You're an insignificant creature desperately clinging on to life like the rest of the scum in this town. Yeah, I know, it's tough. You like Dutch. He's a charming fellow. He makes sense. He's like one of those nature writers from back east, only he takes things a tiny little step too far. Rather than just loving the flowers and the animals and the harmony between man and beast, he shoots people in the head for money and disagreeing with them.
He's a goddamn killer.
Now, I'm not a great intellect, but the metaphysical leap from admiring the flower to shooting a man in the head because he doesn't like the flower is a leap too far. So, I know it's easy. You see, me and Archer, we're the bad guys. We enforce the rules. Now, while the rules may not be perfect, they're really not so bad.
Exactly. What's the alternative?
See, I'll tell you what the alternative is. It's not complicated. It's about one man and his gun versus another man. Sure, civilization may be dull, but the alternative, Mr. Marston, is hell.
And the way you enforce this civilization, this freedom for men to like or not like flowers, or whatever in God's name you were just talking about, is to kidnap a man's wife and son?
Well, I know there's contradictions. I'm not going to lie to you. Yeah, as I said, I'm not a great intellect. Now, after the debacle with the army and the bank, we have to put Mr. Vanderlyn to rest ourselves. Will you help us?
Do I have any choice?
Now that you mention it, no.
Then what was that pretty speech in aid of?
No, rightly no, but it sure felt good saying it.
Shall we, Mr. Marston?
Let's go. Finger off that trigger until we get out of Blackwater. Marston! Why in the hell are you shooting?
Hey! Have you seen this? Here they come! Here they come! Look, they brought the machine gun!
I get them! Let's see if we can put this to rest once and for all, shall we?
Come quick! Take a look at this thing! Have you seen this? He's got a gun on the back!
And oh my, more day!
Here they come! Look, they brought the machine gun!
What's the word, Captain?
We spotted one of Dutch's men about an hour ago. I think he took the bait.
Let's get in position then. Have your men ready to run them down if you have to.
Dismissed! Load weapons and get to the sandbag! Move!
Are you ready to finish this, Mr. Marston?
I guess so.
Hold your fire until I give the word. There they are! Open fire!
That's too damn close! We'll kill you all!
Fingers on the triggers, boys! Target's on the horizon! Fire at will!
This is an ugly business, partner!
Everybody stay alert! There they are! Open fire! If we have to follow them into the woods. Can't you hold this thing steady for them?
I'm trying my best, sir.
They're hiding behind the rocks. Gun them down.
Take them down.
Keep them back!
Who wants me down?
about me!
Where are they coming from? They're like rats!
Well, Mr. Marston, it seems like your mentor, Dutch, no longer looks quite so kindly to his student.
That man is insane.
So it seems.
I think we need to get him before sundown.
As you say, Captain. Otherwise, he'll be gone again.
And what if I say no?
Now, before I shoot you myself, let me just point out the obvious. The one person we have left that can appeal to Mr. Vanderlyn is the last person we know who knows him. Your wife.
That won't be necessary. Mr. Ross, Captain, let's go.
Mount up, men. Let's move out.
Let's go. Hey.
You're the one who's gonna kill him?
Dutch? Yep, that's what they keep telling me. But if you feel like doing it, please be my guest. Let's go.
gate open. Move, soldier! Man, move into the village! Marston, use that gas gun! We'll take him out from the bridge!
Is that all you've got?
Massacre.
Right, Marston. We'll take two men with us. The rest will stay here and take care of the wounded. They'll plant charges at the gate. You and I will provide the cover fire. This is it, man! Let's get that gate down! Get ready to hold off their fire, Marston. Up top! Cover them!
Coming. I'm coming for you, sir.
That's enough! Come on!
It's me and you, John. You should have stayed at home.
I suggest you follow me.
This is the United States.
You damn.
You're going, Calvin. Ah, damn. It's over, John.
I ain't leaving here without you.
You're just like me, John. You can't change who you are.
I ain't like you. That's where you're wrong!
Hello again, John.
Hello, Dutch.
We gotta stop meeting like this.
Sure.
I got a plan, John.
You always got a plan, Dutch.
This is a good one.
I don't doubt it.
We can't always fight nature, John. We can't fight change. Can't fight gravity. We can't fight nothing. My whole life, all I ever did was fight.
Then give up, Dutch.
But I can't give up, neither. I can't fight my own nature. That's a paradox, John. You see?
Then I have to shoot you.
When I'm gone, they'll just find another monster. They have to. Because they have to justify their wages.
That's their business.
Our time has passed, John.
So at the end, you didn't have the guts to shoot him.
The man's dead, Ross.
Sure. Can I see your gun? Oh, trust me. It looks better in the report that way.
Where's my family?
Your wife was killed in a prison riot last week. So, I'm only joking, dear boy. They were sent back to that Scrabble ranch of yours in Beecher's Hope. They're quite safe and sound.
They better be.
Thank you, Mr. Marston, for everything. I know this wasn't easy for you, but I have to say, you've done your country proud.
Yeah, exactly. See you around, John. Try to stay out of trouble. Come on, Archer. Let's go find somebody else we can annoy.